Today we're taking a look at the Omen Gaming Hub by HP, and this is another useful free utility that you can use on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And basically what it does is it also optimizes your computer for gaming, and it has a lot of other useful features as well. So if we just have a quick look at the description here, it can basically monitor your CPU, GPU and RAM, and also your network performance. It also has some optimizations for games. You can optimize your RGB lighting. It's got a network booster. Got some overclocking features, and then it's also got performance control. Now, one thing to note here is not all of the features are available on all PCs. So if you see something working on this video and you can't get it to work on your computer, that's probably why. But nonetheless, this app has pretty good reviews, and I do think this app comes pre-installed on some HP gaming laptops, most probably. But you can use it on any computer. It doesn't have to be an HP. And that's what we're going to be looking at in this video. So you can get it from the official Microsoft page here, and you can also get it from the Microsoft Store if you have that installed. I don't have that installed on this computer, so I'm just going to download it from this website here, which will download an executable file for us to install the Omen Gaming Hub. But I'm going to click on this Omen Gaming Hub installer executable file, and it's going to open this installation wizard, which will then start downloading and installing the Omen Gaming Hub. Once it's finished installing, it's also going to launch automatically. So on first launch, we've got this welcome message that says, what if we could clean up, organize, and optimize our hard drive with a cleaner? What if we could enhance performance for the apps that need it the most with a booster? Organize and launch all our games no matter where we bought them. And we don't need a gaming machine to have it perform like one. We can go ahead and explore this app. So let's go ahead and click on OK. I'm just going to accept all of this license terms. And then we've got a quick walkthrough. So if we need a boost, we can use booster, and it's automatically turned on to optimize our CPU, memory, and network processes, enhancing our gameplay experience. And then for additional optimization, we can explore the cleaner and booster settings. So we'll have a look at that. We can use the Omen Gaming Hub to organize all our games, and we don't need to have different launchers up and running. Next, we can get access to exclusive discounts and check the greatest deals on games, memberships, collectibles, and more. And then we can also download and share the coolest desktop wallpapers. We can have a look at our system's vitals. And then if we're ever lost, we can just click up here, and it's going to walk us through what we can do with the Omen Gaming Hub. So I'm just going to click on done, and then let's have a look at this app for ourselves. So right here on the homepage, we can see some offers. Then we've got some widgets that shows us our CPU, GPU, and RAM utilization. We can see our recently played games. Booster is currently on, which boosts all our games. We've got top deals that we can have a look at. Our favorite games, and then we've got a gallery. So I'm just going to start going through these tabs one by one. We've got home right now. Overlays, we can toggle some overlays and switch that on. If I click on that, it basically gives us overlays for our CPU, GPU, RAM, FPS, and our network speeds. And we can choose between different views. So we've got a compact view, and then we've got a normal view. So right now I have both of them selected. So we can move it wherever we want. The same with the one up here. And then we can also pin it so it stays there. So this is pretty cool if you want to have a look at that at all times. Generally, I don't enable that, but you can also click on the ellipsis menu here, and then you can choose what you want to see. So if, for example, you only wanted to have an FPS counter, you can just have the FPS enabled, and then you can basically just put this anywhere on the screen, and then you'll be able to see your FPS at all times. But like I said, I generally don't use this, so I'm just going to turn that off. To open this menu, you've got a hotkey, Shift and F2. Then we can go back to the Omen Gaming Hub. We've got some different settings here where we can change the hotkey, the background opacity, color, and all of that. I'm just going to close that for now, and we can move on to the next tab, which is Shop Games. It's automatically applied a coupon code for us, and we can basically have a look through the store and purchase any game from here. And you can also see some deals that's going on right now. If we go to My Games, I'm guessing it's just going to do a scan on your system to see what games you have installed, and it's going to show all of your games in a library. Like we saw on the welcome screen of this app, that you can basically launch any game right from within the Omen Gaming Hub. Now, I don't actually have any of these games installed, so these are probably like ads or suggested games for the Google Play Store. But if I had games installed on this computer, it would probably show up here. So boost is turned on by default, and we're going to have a look at that later on once we get to the boost settings. But next we've got a deals tab here, and this is obviously where we can get the best deals on games that's currently on sale. But one of the best things here is it actually gives you free games that you can claim on different platforms. So this one is on Epic Games. This one is on Steam. That one's also on Steam. So basically, you can go ahead and claim your free copy of these games. So this free games feature in itself, to me, is worth it having the Omen Gaming Hub installed, even if you don't use the optimizer or if you don't even believe that that even helps your system. The Omen Gaming Hub will notify you of any free games on any of these other platforms, and then you can just go ahead and claim those. So that's a pretty cool feature of the Omen Gaming Hub, and I quite like that. And you can also see some free-to-play games here, and then also the deals that we've discussed before. Then if you go to Gallery, we can download community wallpapers, and you can see there's a lot of different collections and types of wallpapers to choose from. So obviously there will be mostly gaming wallpapers, and then we've also got Omen wallpapers by HP. And I guess for the sake of this video, let's go ahead and change my wallpaper. So I'm just going to select this first one here, and then we've got some different options here. So we can either just set it as the PC background, or we can download it and then set it as the PC background. Now I'm not going to download it right now. I'm just going to set it as my desktop background. And if we minimize the app, you can see obviously that my desktop wallpaper has changed now. So that's pretty cool if you want to use this app to get some cool wallpapers and apply that to your system. Obviously, if we click on see all, we get access to a whole bunch of different wallpapers. And I'm pretty sure all of these are free. And you can just go ahead and select anyone and then set it as your desktop wallpaper, or just download it and save it on your computer. If we go to the optimizer tab and we have a look at the quick setup, is where I'm going to start. So it says the Omen Optimizer allows us to temporarily boost our game with Booster and keeps our PC free of junk with Cleaner for optimal performance. Let's get started. So I'm going to click on Let's Go. We can automatically boost all our games, but that's already turned on by default. We can go in and configure the settings. We're going to have a look at that now. And we can scan and clean the system for junk. So previously on this channel, I've used tools like Microsoft PC Manager, as well as WinToys, which basically does the same thing. And you've got access to this type of thing in Windows itself, but sometimes these apps help some people just get access to those types of things easier. So let's have a look at the booster and configure that. So here on my system, it's detected 2 out of 7 items that should be optimized. And if we have a look at that, it says it should disable automatic updates. So it's temporarily going to disable Windows automatic updates, which is a good thing, in my opinion, especially if you're gaming. And then it's also going to do a memory boost and clear any unused working and standby memory. Then we also have some other options here, which isn't selected at the moment, like processor optimization, which is going to optimize CPU scheduling, and it's going to disable energy saving features. We can disable file and printer sharing, which I'm guessing is going to improve network performance. I'm not too sure, but that's what I'm guessing. And then we can also temporarily disable the Windows key, so we don't accidentally press that and tab out of the game. And we can also temporarily disable automatic background video recording when playing a game. You probably don't want that if you're using that to record gameplay, but that is an option. And then we can also clear the clipboard history to release memory. So right now, both of these are selected. So because the booster is turned on, these two settings that are selected is automatically going to be applied. I can also apply the processor optimization and clear the clipboard history. So all 4 of those items will now be automatically applied. Now, if you're having any issues with this, you can obviously just turn off the booster, or you can click on reset to default. If you go to this next tab here and have a look at the processes, we can basically see all of our background processes, the same that Task Manager would show. And we can see the memory that it's using. And then we can basically go ahead and probably select one of these apps, like let's just select UniGet UI as an example. And I'm guessing we have to click on manual boost for these options to take effect. So I thought these would be automatically applied. It seems that I'm just selecting the options that I want to use, and then I'm going to click on manual boost to actually apply those settings. So here we've got basic Windows services that can be safely turned off to free up system resources while gaming. And we can see some of these are already stopped, but some of the others are running. So I think if you want to try and get some performance optimizations while gaming, you can just go ahead and select all of these and then apply a manual boost and see if you have any performance increases while gaming. Some people say these apps are just placebo. Personally, I don't know. In this video, I'm not going to be doing a benchmark or anything like that. I'm just showing you the app, and you can go ahead and do the tests on your own system, because there's so many different hardware configurations out there. And even if I do have a performance increase on my PC, it doesn't mean you're going to have one on yours. So That's stuff you can test on your own. But if we have a look at the next tab here, which is advanced services, which is also Windows services, but these may disrupt normal operation of your PC. So if you don't know what these are and what they do, it's best just to leave these services alone. But honestly, you can go ahead and play around with this yourself and then see if you have any performance increases while gaming. I'm just going to go ahead and click on manual boost. And as you can see, it's then going to apply the five items that I selected in the booster configuration here. And obviously, if you selected more, they would all be applied now. So booster is active. And if you want to undo this or turn it off, you can just click on restore. And it's then going to restore those settings to default. If you do test this out after watching this video, or if you've tested it out before, please let me know in the comments down below if the booster actually gave you a performance increase on your system while gaming. But we're going to be moving on to the cleaner tab here. And honestly, this is just like a disk cleanup tool, I'm guessing. We can scan our system, we can review the items to clean, and then we can clean the system, and we can also do scheduled cleaning. So let's just have a quick look at this. We can do a scan. It's going to do a scan for all of the system files. So basically, we've got the recycle bin, which is quite large. I need to clear that out. Then we've got Windows temp files, installer temp files, the default download folder, which isn't selected to be cleaned by default. You'll have to go ahead and click on that, but I'm not going to do that now. We've got downloaded installers, recent files, and then a whole bunch of other stuff. And we can also clear the browser cache. Let's go ahead and do that. And it's also going to clear out some other things like history and session, all of that. And then we've also got game platforms like Steam, and we can clear the cache there. I'm not going to be doing that now, but I will go ahead and click on clean so we can clean out these files that I just selected here. And then we can see the status of it here on the left. And now it's complete. So it seems like with these exclamation marks here, some of these items couldn't be cleaned. And it doesn't really give us any more info other than saying that this item couldn't be cleaned. But it's probably because some of those files are in use because they are system files. So I'm just going to ignore that for now. If you go to the next tab here, it says no items were selected for optimization. So I don't know if that's just on my PC. But we can also restore all Windows settings back to default. I'm definitely not going to be doing that. So I'll just close that. And then on the next tab here, it also says no items were selected for optimization. So I'm not completely sure if that's just on my PC or what's supposed to happen here. I obviously don't have any items to select for optimization or cleaning. So then obviously we can use the scheduler to have it run automatically at a certain time and day of the week, and also show us a notification if you want that. Personally, I don't use these type of things. You can do all of this in Windows itself, but if you want to use the app for that, you're welcome. And then if we go back to quick setup, we can see the booster and the cleaner that we just used. Next, if we go to Light Studio, we have to download and install the Omen Light Studio for the advanced RGB lighting effects on our setup. I'm not going to be doing that in this video. If we have a look at the My PC tab, we've got the system vitals, which basically shows us the utilizations again and the top processes. We also get a storage breakdown of our drives here. And then we've got different modes here. We've got a basic view, we've got an advanced view if we want to have some more info. And this is also pretty cool because you can see your temps here and just have a nice dashboard for all of that. And we've also got an info tab here telling us the model of our motherboard, what RAM we have installed, the operating system, processor. It basically just gives us a whole bunch of info with regards to our hardware. So after having a look at the Omen Gaming Hub app, to me, the best things about it are the deals tab here, where we can get free games and we can see where we can get those games. I think that's really cool because you can basically collect a whole bunch of games. And I know some people like doing that. Even if they never play the game, they just collect a whole bunch of different games just to say that they have it and they're basically game collectors. The other thing is having access to all of these wallpapers here. If we go to the gallery tab, there's really a whole bunch of awesome wallpapers that you can get from the community, and they're all free. And this can just help you to effortlessly change your wallpaper from time to time and leave your PC looking fresh. And then lastly, I guess this booster is also quite a nice function, which gives you some control over some of the services in Windows and helps you basically just optimize your PC a little bit more for gaming. But like I said, I haven't personally tested this. Leave a comment down below if you have tested it and tell me if it actually does give you a performance increase on your PC while gaming. But with that all being said, if you got any value out of this video, please consider giving it a like. And if you want to support this channel, you can check out my YouTube members section. Shout out to all of my existing members. Your support really helps out the channel, no matter what tier you're on. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.